Yeah, he's gonna flood something and...
Oh, he's gonna do a honey challenge! He's doing a honey challenge!
Yeah. He's putting a controller in like a tub of honey.
Hell yeah!
And he's submerging as more donations come in, if I remember correctly.
But on top of that, his incentive is he's gonna drench a hot dog in ketchup. So...
Yeah, that's ridiculous.
I hate that.
But okay, as a roughly Blues Brothers themed event and therefore a Chicago themed event, literally dipping a hot dog in ketchup and consuming it may in fact put you on a list of criminals.
Yes.
You are now wanted in the state of Chicago.
Okay. Did I put the game in yet? No, I'm an idiot.
The state.
State of Chicago.
That's
state
correct.
State of Chicago. A foreigner sliding into the call here to react to State of Chicago?
Yeah. State of Chicago in the country of Illinois.
Yo, I'm from around the state of Chicago. I'm in that area.
Yeah, what's that you from?
I was born and raised in Calumet City, which is why I have such a love for the Blues Brothers and
The province of Calumet City.
Yeah. Where's my damn Wiimote? Okay. Well, let me get this a little more out of the way.
The state of Chicago and the Grand Duchy of Illinois.
Well, everyone, unfortunately, I'm doing it again. I'm playing Heathcliff the Fast and Furious. I'm sorry.
Heathcliff, he's a cat.
This is by and away, by like a country mile, the worst Wii game I've ever played. It is easily the least fair, one of the craziest, stupid ass things I've ever played in my life for so many reasons. I'm really excited to share it with you. We're going to pretend I have a Wii wheel. I do not. Yeah, I'm glad there's so many people in chat who have seen this before who are just like, no, not again. No. Too late. Look at those captions crop, too. They seem to have done a weird little crop here.
What's it? Did I hear anything? It's just very gross.
There we go. Yes. Okay. All right. So this is... Heathcliff, the Fast and the Furious. This is one of the most broken, but also most difficult pieces of Cuso I have ever witnessed in my time on this earth. And I have witnessed quite a few.
You should probably slow down on that drink, by the way.
I'm gonna do a new profile as opposed to going through. I didn't know we had a choice here of two different Heathcliffs. Heathcliff, but he's got some
other Heathcliff.
Yeah, Heathcliff, but he's got some angle problems, or Heathcliff, but covered in bullshit and wants a hug.
God, he's so lumpy either way. I hate him.
The part of this menu that rules, by the way, is they expect you to, like, navigate this menu when you're holding it like this, but then to put your name in, you have to hold it like this. It's great.
As a cat person, I have to say, Heathcliff is not my favorite cat.
That's fucked up.
God,
I know.
You have to use the 2 button to confirm, by the way. Which is not the A button, not the thing that while you're pointing is right here. No, the one down here. That guy. Hell yeah, dude. This game sucks every step of the way. Well, let's see if I can beat World 1. We're gonna start on medium. You're gonna think this game is like... Okay, there's just a bunch of comics from beloved cat character Heathcliff. This was like a weird Heathcliff reboot, but can we actually just take a quick second to appreciate how the Heathcliff slowly deteriorate into just whatever this weird blob is in the bottom left panel here? We gave up at that point.
You can see the exact moment they ran out of budget.
I need a better engine. Just like a man's. And again, hey everybody. This is, in fact, still a donation stream for Aki. No incentives here for the next 30 minutes or so, just because I need a break. I've been through a lot today. Look at these textures, though. Can you believe these fucking textures? Oh my god. I want to make sure everyone can see how barely I have to turn this thing. To just really rip it. Oh god. Damn it. God, the music too. Oh, come on. I want to get to a boss fight because I think the people really need to know how unfair and broken the boss fight is in this game. Oh, I got pumpkined. You got jacked. You got jack-o'-lantern.
You got frickin' jacked.
You got frickin' jacked, nerd.
Get out of here. Fucked up thing is, in addition to how incredibly tight it is, when you're really, like, accelerating, you're moving fast.
But, like, not as fast as you'd want.
Ooh. Yeah.
I turned on the base boosters, but... Oh, I got frickin' jacked! Son of a bitch! I just got the biggest outplay when I was jacked. Now I'm last. I'm really close to it.
Well, you're fifth. You're not quite last.
Like, this is the first level of the game, by the way. I feel like I've been doing okay, all things considered. Fifth place. Easy does not make the game easier, for the record. I'm pretty sure there is literally no change between easy and medium. I have not been able to figure it out. So what's... A lot of people know about Incompetech, but who do you think made this game?
I have no idea. Couldn't tell ya.
I can't believe they unearthed an original Moog synth to get this shitty noise. Alright, I'm gonna jack somebody else.
Carpenter for fuckers.
Carpenter butt. Mm-hmm. Carpenter boot!
I've been trying to find a single thing appealing about the presentation of this game, and there's nothing.
Oh, do you like that generic text? That generic aerial? Ooh. Heathcliff sound effect going wahoo is pretty fun. Also, there's tons of rubber banding, but never for you. Just for the record. The AI will always just continue to drive perfectly and never interfere with each other. It is hard to overstate how... I might just load my profile, actually, because I think I should have a save at the boss, so I do have a backup strat, just in case. Don't worry, everybody. I have a backup plan in case I can't ever win at Heathcliff again. Oh, the steering is such cheeks. Like, how long have I been driving basically perfectly at this point? And I have made zero progress on the catch-up.
In fact, they've actually continued to widen the catch-up.
I wouldn't even know if there were other characters in this game if you hadn't run into someone that one time.
No, it should have been me.
No. That's famous Heathcliff voice that he's got right there.
All right. I'm going to try and just go out to my save and see if we can just get to the boss. Put me on that blarmp. Heathcliff gloves. Oh, right, it was just world select, so I never actually got to choose the boss, I don't think. Hey, at least I can show off the other tracks. Let's do that a bit.
Of Heathcliff's hometown. Also, yeah, why is Heathcliff capitalized like that? That's not how it is.
Yeah, you make a good point. Did they not even check this enough to not check, like, the brand? They didn't check the brand?
Is this a Saga situation? Like, compared to Unlimited Saga where they didn't capitalize the G?
Maybe. Cliff is a surname. Ah, the Heathcliff.
Heathcliff Jr.
Fighting Heathcliff team. Yeah. Three of four, baby. But yeah, hey, this is a charity fundraiser event, by the way, for Akihabara Arcade. I don't want to plug it too much because we've already done my goal originally and then also like an additional my goal. So, hey, thanks. That's all I really want is just thanks. Hey, thanks. I'm sitting here in a banana suit playing a bad Wii game. Hey, thanks. I appreciate it. It means a lot. Thank you for being the people that support the people. That's what we need right now. And again, means a lot. I feel like I have been driving literally perfectly this whole time.
Sam.
Oh.
Do that again and you'll be sorry.
Oh, I got freaking jacked! Unbelievable. Oh! I'm getting clowned on. I'm getting big clowned on. Oh, Lord.
And now that you're in six, you'll never catch up.
Yup. I got freaking jacked. Now
you
I'm
made
last.
One mistake, and you're done. Not even made a mistake, you got jacked, and you couldn't really do much about that.
Yeah. The good news is they gave Heathcliff a gun. By the way, look at the bullet casings dropping out of the back of the gun. Doesn't that look good? Just like real bullet casings, and not like some weird beans?
Those are extremely some weird beans.
Those are some weird beans, yeah.
The bean hauler over here is what that is. It just... fires shelled beans.
Excuse me, sir. I believe your bean is sick. Your bullets are sick. They look like beans. Okay, I forgot. It's a homing missile, but since I was too close to a wall, they all just homed into the missile, hit me, and then knocked me into the... and I died.
I've got a weird, dumb nerd gun. It's super good, and it always kills my target, but it sounds so dumb. It sounds like an idiot. Also, it shoots beans.
So yeah, hey everybody. I hope you're looking forward to Smite's Bad Idea Corner, because I am. It's nice because I'm going to be able to take a break for a little bit here, but it's even more nice because I'm going to watch Smite do something really dumb, and it's going to be great. So, I'm just thinking, have them donations ready, because I would like to see Smite's Night ruined. for the people. For the people. Hey, for a good cause. Let me be clear here. I want to see my friend Smite's Night ruined, because that means he was very successful.
Look at how fucking far back you are.
Yeah.
You made one basic, like, in a Mario Kart, that you wouldn't be able to recover from that, no problem. That would have been just standard, really. And this, you do that once, you're never recovering from it, and in fact, it's gonna get worse.
It's a pretty common example people use of like, oh, it's so easy to make a cart game, that's why they make so many of them, they just shit them out. But I've seen Beyond the Veil, I've seen what happens when they don't successfully make a cart game. And the good news is, that's actually what our next game is too. Now that I've shown you the surreal depths of how unbelievably difficult this game is, for no good reason. There's a lot of archives of me like playing a little bit more, getting to a boss, and then the boss just randomly flipping me around 720 or I guess it would be like 900 degrees, and then I just land and I'm facing the wrong way and just like drive off into the void. Very good stuff. Yeah, the steering's very bad.
I'm sorry.
You can see what I'm doing. That's the joy, right?
haven't really been here for Garfield Kart, but what the fuck are you driving?
This is, Heathcliff's big, dragster. It's got a bunch of pipes, because the pipes make it faster. As we all know, this is common science. We don't need to be ridiculous here. We all know that.
Yeah.
Okay, got some more jams. Alright, well, the good news is, if you think I only brought one shitty game that's kart racing, you ain't been here before.
Shit.
You're not from here. Let me grab this.
What do you got?
We got some more Karted Race.
I have washed the fruit, by the way.
Excellent.
Yeah, showing the boss fight, I thought I had a save that would get me to it. It turns out, no, I would have to successfully beat all of World 1 again on medium. And we don't have that kind of time.
That's something that takes hours.
Yeah, that literally takes me multiple hours on occasion. So, I have two here. I'm gonna let Call decide. We'll probably only get one of these, because it's almost time for Smite's Bad Idea Corner. But we have Mythmakers Super Kart GP and
okay,
Sled Shred featuring the Jamaican bobsled team.
I would go for the first one myself.
Harry Potter.
I like the first one, but Jamaican bobsled team is really tempting.
Yeah, right. Like,
I'm voting for Sled Shred.
All right, let's get some Sled Shred in here. I would like to apologize in advance for any moments where this game perhaps lacks sensitivity in its delivery.
It's not even actually Cool Runnings the video game, you know?
It's not.
It's just fucking...
It just has the Jamaican bobsled team in it.
It is, we off could not... Brand. We made a game for Cool Runnings and it was too bad, so Disney would not give us the rights. Or whoever made Cool Runnings. Oh, this looks like it's loading nicely. Oh, is it going to be royalty-free ska or reggae all the way down? Oh, baby. Oh. Yeah, now
royalty-free ska, though.
Yeah, now that you put it that way, unlicensed Cool Runnings video game for the Nintendo Wii says a lot. Because when was the film Cool Runnings out? I feel like...
In the 90s!
In the 90s. Mid-90s. Yeah, I feel like Cool Runnings was
a kid.
Very much in the 90s.
93.
93. October.
Not even the mid-90s.
Yeah, early 90s.
Amazing. Well... Apparently, I have played this at some point in the past and put in Bean Boy as my
Bean
name.
Bean Boy.
So,
wow.
Apparently, I've played this before. I don't remember it, so I think we're good. But I'm glad that it was Bean Boy. The fact that the Bean Boy joke has been going for that goddamn long. Well, who do we want to play? I guess. A quirky and mysterious man. What
is this Monster Hunter language? What does he say?
If you want a sled shred, you'll need one of these. Don't move me back up.
Just here. Getting some simlish here.
Yeah.
Wicked! It's Tubin! This isn't sled, we're Tubin!
It's just Tubin, but
it's Tubin.
Excellent. Yeah, this isn't bobsled. For the record, this is not bobsled. Bobsled is a very specific thing.
This bobsled is like long, rigid sides,
It's got some, you know, some skis on it, oh, some ridges.
Also, we're in the desert now for some reason.
Oh no. So this one is, I have to go left and right, but also tip forward and back. I think ducking also makes me go faster. It ended up being royalty fraud. It ended up being royalty free ska in the end anyway. Despite everything, right. It's royalty free ska again. God, you can't just go ba-da-da-da in the middle of a ska track like that.
That's what I think of when I hear this.
Fair.
I also think of ska go-go on DDR, but that's different. That's a different story. And that ridiculous run you got at the end.
Oh, jump boost? Hop boosting? Oh, they're dead now. I found the tech. And it is, you can just speed up at no cost at any time. 1-800-AREYOUHOPPIN.com.
It seems better than Heathcliff.
I think so, yeah. I'm not in last is part of it. Also, it controls like... I mean, it's still Wii Motion controls without a Wii Motion Plus or anything, so still very bad. But compared to Heathcliff, right. It's very bad because of the equipment as opposed to very bad because of, and then a long series of question marks that I am not sure. I have no good reason for it.
You beat Chuck the Clown, so.
Yeah.
And fuck that guy.
I want everyone to know I'm glad I didn't end up making a Dark Donald. That was definitely, or Dark Ronald. That was one of the plans, but, I did not have time to go get a Burger King burger and also or a McDonald's whatever and dehydrate it. What have you played a racing game where you're supposed to steer with the nunchuck, which only has an accelerometer and not full gyro? Or are you talking about Billy the Wizard? Because I beat that game. Billy the Wizard was pretty amazing.
It's just sledding every hill I can.
All right, but Coach, when do we team up with three other people to fall down a hill at highway speeds?
Older all the time.
Do you ever think about how terrifying, like, skeleton is and, like, just real bobsled?
Of course, constantly.
I think about how skeleton is maybe the most terrifying thing a human being can do quite often. I would go skydiving 100 times before I would go skeleton once. Like
that's like the two-person luge.
Skeleton is the
no,
one where
skeleton
it's like
is the one where you have
blades and that's it. Like your ass is on the ground basically. It is ridiculous.
No.
Skeleton is specifically the one where you're on a thin metal sled with just the tiniest bit of a lip in front of you and you're on your stomach going down a ramp that's covered in snow.
Yeah, that
it's head first.
Head first. That's the detail I left out on accident. Yeah, it is in fact a head first event.
Luge is at least still legs first, so you have a crumple zone in place.
Yeah.
Yeah. With luge, you'll probably just destroy your legs. With skeleton, you'll die if you climb with something.
The crumple zone is your neck, which generally... Yeah. Oh no. Did I...
Uh-oh.
Oh, skip! Look at that skip! I'm nice! Ooh, baby! You love a good clip skip! I'm way ahead.
The good shit.
Oh, it's so godlike. I could probably.
I will propose for most terrifying. Seconds. For most terrifying sport, I will also suggest wingsuits.
Ooh, wingsuits? And the other one is maybe Hyalai. Because Hyalai just.
Oh, you can whip that thing really hard.
Yeah.
I like moving faster than any other ball. That in all sports, on average, a highlight ball moves on average around 130 miles per hour, if I remember right.
Like, legitimately, what they use to launch it to get a ton of extra force in it is a really similar device to like when you're learning to shoot shotguns or whatever. You throw like hunting clays, and the main device they use for it is just like a really long stick with like a curved cup on the end so that you can just hold it and have incredible amounts of leverage and just let it rip. And a Hyalai racket is basically that, except it's all the scoop so they can catch it easier. So it's just like a 3-foot scoop that you just are fucking ripping it. And people who play Hyalai fucking play Hyalai. Like they play the hell out of it. So they are scary good at it. Hyalai is terrifying. Hyalai also is, to this day, probably my favorite Jackass bit because it is the one where they very clearly did not realize how bad of a time they were in for. Now, why are we doing a snowball fight?
I don't remember that bit. I remember watching a decent amount of Jackass.
Jackass High Alive was really something special. It's just great because they very quickly, like, they're like, oh, yeah, this shouldn't be too bad. And then immediately they see one of these High Alive balls rip and they realize it's going at like almost 200 miles an hour. And they're like, like, they look at each other and they're like, are we going to be okay? And then they're like, oh, maybe hit us in the thigh first. We'll see how that goes.
Like, when I describe the balls moving on average 130 miles per hour, that's the average throw with one.
Average.
And that's still faster than, like, some of the fastest fucking speed balls in baseball.
You ever get hit and by also, something the ball, going 9 miles an hour?
The ball in High Alive is also, like, a rock covered in leather.
Yeah.
So.
Yeah, that's the other thing. There is no forgiveness in a High Alive ball.
Yeah.
Yeah, it is hard material wrapped in also pretty hard material. Like, leather gets very hard. You may know it from armor leather as well.
Yeah, leather gets hard very fast. It is not actually a soft material.
Yeah.
You can make it a soft material, but you actually have to treat it to be like that.
You have to put a lot of work into it, yeah.
Biker leather is not like most leather. Biker jacket leather, you know?
Mm-hmm. Oh, I got freaking bumped.
Yeah, you're in the Rat Pack now. You gotta get
apparently
out
the world record fastball is 105 miles per hour, so
whoa!
The average speed is faster than the world record fastball in baseball.
I mean, it makes sense, right? Because, well, like, the pitchers are just throwing it directly out of their hand. Highlight yep, players have a fucking,
have instrument.
Yeah, imagine if you just had 3 additional feet of arm, so you could just have that much stronger of a lever.
Listen,
and it's
if
really
you,
curved, too.
If you were about a giant, you know, like, let's say you're about, you know, 6 meters tall, okay, and you had a highlight scoop on there, right? When you throw your object, you would be basically a trebuchet launching a 90 kilogram object at roughly 300, 400 meters.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
Just throwing that out there.
You just become a trebuchet at some point.
Exactly.
Can I charge jumps? Can I negative edge a jump here and get a better one? Ooh, maybe I can. The jumps in this game are mysterious. Everything else I kind of get, the jumps are throwing me off real bad.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, okay.
Do you think that maybe the jumps are just supposed to, like, launch you in the direction of the slope that you're on, but because you're always on a slope, they're constantly launching you forward?
Maybe. That would make sense. In some way. In some universe, that makes sense. In the universe, possibly, of Jamaican Sled Shred featuring the Jamaican bobsled team. Featuring no bobsledding. I was point blank on that fool and threw a snowball left and it just didn't hit him. The auto-targeting when you throw them forward is absolutely ridiculous though, so. Oh my god. Am I about to get scammed out again? Blue shelled again?
It just gives you momentum perpendicular to whatever polygon you're on top of right now.
Could be. Could also be because I'm leaning forward so far that when I jump, it's like leaning it forward. No, come on. Good enough.
Came in second.
Yeah. By 1/12 of a second.
Okay, clowns. See, now you have Skeleton, the sport, right? Okay. Now here's the thing. You can have two people going down two separate slopes that would collide in the middle if you were doing Skeleton, right? Now, what if we gave both of them a lance and a shield? What about Skeleton Joust? See, now I think
that Skeleton would no longer be an appropriate name because they would now be missing their skeletons.
Yeah.
You'd get maybe one run.
Like, okay. Here's how violent of an idea that would be. Like, my brain just parsed it as, like, two things diving at each other full speed, and the only connection I could make is, like, yeah, like in Killer Queen, the game, where you dive on someone and fucking murder them instantly. Like, it would be like that, but twice.
Yeah, it's, you have invented a very roundabout way to perform double executions.
Yeah. But it would be really fun.
It'd be like loading two people into cannons, pointing the cannons at each other, and then firing. Like.
Okay, other more humane option, though. So you have skeleton. Except you put a horse on that tiny sled.
Okay. Now they have to joust, but the horse has to maintain its balance on the skeleton.
You have to lock the horse's feet to the sled if you're going to pull this off.
You weld the horseshoes to the sled.
Nice.
Now we're talking,
and then
yes.
You just nail the horse to the sled via the shoes. Very smart. Yeah, yeah, yeah. Okay, this works. New sport coming in hot, everybody. I want to try this smash attack.
A horse can just be a bobsled. It weighs as much as four people.
Oh no.
And besides, y'all saying like, oh, this kills the horse and all that. The thing is, that would require horses to exist first.
That's true.
Yeah,
this,
no one's ever
we
seen
are
a
operating
horse.
Under the assumption that like horses were real for this.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, when they really weren't.
Like, look, I get it. Horses, it's ridiculous, right? Because artists have spent they make all these other variations too and expect us to believe it. Like, I've seen a horse with a horn. I've seen a horse with wings. It's like, this is some real deviant art shit. Like, just make a real animal, like a dragon or something. Like, it's ridiculous.
Giraffe jousting, though. Hold on.
Isn't that just actual giraffes? Don't they, like, neck slap?
That's well, less yeah, of a jousting, more of just a fucking beatdown.
Yeah, hey, let's get jousting.
Yes.
Honk, honk. I'm always jousting.
You know, which regional accent would say jest instead of joust?
Can you go for a jest real quick? You want? That's something that fucking Coach Z would say, is what it is.
And respect.
It's me, I'm the jesty man.
What can I say? We're the impractical jesters.
How am I in second? How is this possible?
You managed to take a route where there were no snowballs flying at your ass. Congratulations.
But also, he passed by someone who was nearby, and like, he was still in second. And then somehow that one passed you again.
A mystery.
Now you're in third. Okay.
Well, he fell down.
But where's the third asshole? Where's the caveman?
On a different path. The caveman
am
is
I
on
glad
a different
that
timeline.
I'm on this path
we'll
and you're on that path.
And
when that's on that
and
path, I just remember I'm on that
here
path.
And the caveman's down there, so where
and is he's the sheriff.
Caveman's the sheriff. No, where I want to know is where's the caveman?
Hey, Coach. Where's the caveman?
Where is the caveman?
Oh, he's jousting. Jousting. I can't even do it jousting. Now.
No, you just have to channel your inner squat energy, yeah, and you can get a chance.
Okay, so an actual thing that happened in the English language was the Great Vowel Shift. With at some point in the 14th, 15th century, where a lot of vowels just kind of traded places for how they sound. We need to conspiracy theory up that no, there was an even further shift. The true vowels are further buried beyond.
Well, I'm gonna try and do that power up slam
words were
attack.
Too powerful, so they had to be sealed away. Fucking up all the vowels.
Oh, I'm electric Blanca Sub-Zero. If anyone comes close to me, they're dead. I'm ready. I have my attack charged.
Oh, I may have sampled the maraschino.
Hey.
Oh, boy.
Hey, do you like those? They're the worst, right? Hey, everybody. Boys
Jamie
Cobb has never tried a maraschino cherry before. And he was like, yeah, I'll eat a bunch of cherries like Chuchel. I'm like, oh, you should have an incentive to eat instead maraschino cherries. And he's like, oh, are they that bad? I'm like, yes.
Yeah. You're not really.
They're bad. Didn't enjoy them that much. I got good cherries and I got bad cherries.
Yeah.
Voice of Dog just updating us with, hey, I bought like 2 pounds of cherries. You think that'll be good? It's just like
2 pounds. Yeah, I wish.
I Well, either way, I'm going to hit up Smite, who's going to be starting up his block here very shortly. I'm going to see if he's about ready, and we can take some time to run through donations. And yeah, maraschino cherries, by the way, are the ones that are the worst cherries that exist. So they, like, they flush them out of all their flavor and then soak them in the most sickly sweet artificial cherry fluid. So it's super sugary, super fake cherry flavor. It's just awful. They're like incandescent red. They're like waxy and gross, and they like pop in a weird way. Oh, they're so bad. Like, honestly, maraschino cherry, I don't know, people say it's good on a cocktail. I have yet to agree. Like, as someone who's had many cocktails with them, like, it, honestly, like, I get it if you put it in an old fashioned. I understand. But also, how about a real cherry instead? Yeah, how about a real one? How about we get some
real
cherries?
What if you actually had, like, cherries? Yeah.
Yeah, like, just cherries. They're so, like, oh, God. I just, yeah, like, a good maraschino for what it's worth is another thing that's also okay. But, like, main maraschino cherries, like, the main ones are just so awful.
Curse a real cherry?
Also, you're not, the thing is too, is you're not supposed to like eat maraschino cherries raw ever, like they're as a garnish kind of thing. And hey, I'm sure some people like them. I'm sure you also would like some really gross ass syrup, which is all the maraschino cherry is.
We just soaked it.
Terrible syrup with a cherry on the outside. Ooh. Oh, also, there is the man of the hour, Smite. Hello, Smite. Yeah. Oh, are you want to hop in and talk about your maple syrup trials you're about to endure while we get ready to do the old switcheroo?
We have a moment for a couple donations before Smite starts up with that.
Yeah, love syrup.
All right. So we have $5 from Cosmic Afro. Cosmic Afro here. I'm sad my own local LAN arcade bar closed down last year, and I hope yours won't close down either. Here's some money. We've got $50 from Anonymous saying, this is my dog's girlfriend's brother's favorite arcade. We've got a $10 Anonymous donation just saying, the mint bond with the ranch protein.
It did, though. The Coke bound, or the rum bound the ranch proteins.
We've got a $50 donation from Mangaka. Holy moly, Ty, 15K raised for Akihabara? You are a literal god. Shoutouts to the GDQ crew and all COFGC. You stepped up to help save our precious home. Can't wait to see all of you again. Signed, Mangaka.
Nearly 23K at this point.
Yeah, no, it's fucking wild.
Oh my god, yeah, thank you all. Again, like, it... Again, when I started this out, I was like... I mean, I think it'd be nice if I got like $2,000, and I plan on donating $1,000. So if we get $1,000, I think that'd be nice. And now it's just kind of like, no, no, we're doing all of it. Thank you all so much. And
we have one more. Yeah. Oh, a few more. Yeah, we've got a Project LG donating here. I just had to donate towards Ty's saving of the rec center wearing a banana suit.
There is also Nullity donating $69.69 with just good.
Good.
That's good. Message.
Good. Thank you.
Good. Good.
I mean,
just like Orion Hunter DX, it's good posting, you know?
Yeah.
Anonymous with 25 saying, pump them for Aki. And another Anonymous for 10 saying, just love the streams, Ty. And that's all of the donation like messages for now. If you want to get more of those red, send them in, you know?
Yeah. All right. Well, I'm gonna go ahead and take stream down and vanish for a second. And right on time, Smite is gonna go ahead and pop up. And you know what? I think it'll be better if you just stay around for just a minute or two here, and I'll let Smite tell you what he's doing. Cause in advance.
Godspeed.
Thank you, Smite. All right. I'm gonna go ahead and.